Today's video will be a follow-up video of my video on the Titan Black. This time will be two Titan Blacks in SLI. Here are the specs for the Titan Black. I went over it in my last video a little bit. And I will be showing you how to get Battlefield 5 to work properly with SLI. I will get right to the benchmarks, and like always, thank you for watching. So I'll be showing you how I got Battlefield 5 SLI to work. I did not come up with these settings. I got the info from THC. Here's his YouTube channel. So what you do is you gotta download NVIDIA Profile Inspector. Open that up here. As soon as that opens, what you want to do is type in Battlefield. And then on yours, you'll see there'll be a profile with Battlefield 5. I deleted mine, and I'll show you why here. So you click on it, and you'll see Battlefield 5 right up here. And then you click on Delete Profile, and it's going to give you a warning saying that if you delete it, you cannot restore it, and you would have to reinstall your drivers. And that's okay. So what? Then after that, what you do, type in Battlefield. After that, and then you'll see Battlefield 1. Click on that, and what you want to do after that is you want to add an application to this current profile. Click on that, go to your directory for Battlefield 5, and you'll see BFV. Click on that and hit open. Which I did already, because you'll be using the exact same settings as Battlefield 1. After you added Battlefield 5 executable to the Battlefield 1 profile, what you want to do, you do not want to hit apply changes yet. What you want to do is you want to click on here, you click on your File Explorer, then go to this PC. Go to your C drive. You'll see program data. You'll see NVIDIA Corporation. Click on that. Then you'll see DRS. Click on that. You'll see these two files right here. NVDRSDB0.bin and 1.bin. What you want to do is you want to highlight both these. And go to properties and make sure... Mine is read-only right now, but before you hit apply, you want to make sure this is not read-only. Make sure both these boxes are unchecked, okay? So then you go back to NVIDIA Inspector after you make sure the boxes are unchecked. Hit apply a couple times. Hit it 3 or 4 times. Just make sure it's applied. Go back here. After you apply it, right-click on both these files right here. Properties. And make sure you click on read only and hit OK. If you don't, SLI will not work. The downside of doing this is any changes that you make in your NVIDIA control panel will give you an error. And I'll show you that. So let's say I want to turn on DSR. I hit OK and hit apply. It's going to give me an error. See, right there. So you want to make sure, if you got to make any changes to the control panel, you have to go back in there, uncheck read only, make your changes, and then go back in there and make it read only. And another thing I want to go over is, with these changes, and if you play multiplayer on Battlefield 5, I am not sure that... any of these settings will get you banned. So on Battlefield 5, after you apply the settings in NVIDIA Inspector, what you have to do is, when you first get in the game, it's going to be a stuttering mess. It's going to be real slow. What you have to do is you got to go underneath options as soon as you get in the game. Go to video. Go to advanced. Future frame rendering, you have to turn on. As soon as you turn that on, it will smooth right out. And make sure, another thing that you have to do is shut off motion blur. You'll get some a little bit of like jitters here and there. If you don't mind it, you can leave it on, but I would shut off motion blur.
Dreamed of. But death is death, no matter where you are. And suffering is the same in every language.
Call it! Fuck this shit!
Here.